All right, let's get back to it. I wish I could see the map before deciding where to put people, because I don't even know. Is this right? Is this wrong? Am I causing my ninja to die again? I don't know. So our plan to stop the fighting is to literally open the floodgates, cause the lake to drain onto the battlefield, and prevent anyone from being able to fight at all. So in order to win the battle, we need to get people. There's two knights on top of the sluice gate. We need to get people to stand exactly where they are. It's a bit overkill, but I do need to kill this knight. So I'm having my bard sing a healing song to constantly heal us. That's not a whole lot, but his song is fast. The knights on top of the sluice won't actually do anything until you are next to them. So we don't have to worry about turning our backs to them. Interesting that an archer would throw a rock at me instead of actually shooting me. Sometimes the AI is not good. I'll leave that guy to my black mage. That is unfortunate. why would you all line up like that? It's hilarious. But that archer is wearing a Gaia gear, which makes him absorb earth. So shockwave deals earth damage. We're gonna try and slowly make our way back up to our Geomancer to revive him. Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so happy that we actually equipped the ninja's reaction ability. It was such a good idea. Look at this! She's unkillable! Please don't miss. So we could have ended that fight having people stand on the sluice gate levers, but killing everyone is also a way to end the fight. With the lake drained onto the battlefield, no one can really fight anymore. Orin. At some point we meet up with Orin. I'm not sure when, but Orin and Delita's assistant lead us to Cid. So Cid decides to travel with us. Cid is so powerful that it is considered cheating to use him. He has access to both Holy Knight and Dark Knight skills. And he's just ridiculous. So Delita succeeds in his assassination. They have a Cid look-alike. Also be assassinated. So now the army believes their commanders are dead. And the church plays its part, coming forward, mediating a peace between the northern and southern skies. We can't do anything about that, but we still have to go try and save Ulma. That's a lot of battles. Alright. Alright. Cid has the Sword Saint ability. He's got all of this. He can destroy armor weapons at a distance. He can have holy blade abilities, dark blade abilities. He is ridiculous. And I will not use him. One of these days I'll actually do a playthrough where I use all the unique characters, but not today. Not today. The Bracer. Physical attack plus 3. But I would lose some movement. But it's physical attack plus 3. Well, as a geomancer, I might not need the movement, so we'll do that. We'll go ahead and throw the red shoes onto Osric. That's an excuse to use Ramza as a knight. This is a knight weapon. You gain automatic haste, you absorb holy, and you boost holy damage. So that's part of which, that's part of why Cid is amazing, because his holy sword abilities will get boosted by Excalibur. I'm expecting some random battles here. Nope. Can we go 2 for 2? We cannot. Alright. Alright, so we got some Cthulhu-esque mind flayers. The original Final Fantasy... These guys have been around since the original Final Fantasy games, and they were a direct ripoff from first edition D&D, I think. Chance to confuse Ramsa. That would really, really suck if it hit. So I think Mind Flayers are weak to Thunder? Yeah. I just really like Nameless Song. Having, like, buffs on my party is really nice. No matter what buff it is, it's still good. No one's got Gaia gear. Okay. My black mage gets re-raised, which is so nice. I love my ninja now. She's the best. Thank you. real quick. How are we coming on Monk? $1,300. We got a ways to go. So this, if you've played Final Fantasy VII, you might be familiar with that hairstyle. You might be familiar with this interaction. I probably won't, I definitely won't do this side quest. So it's possible to recruit Cloud from Final Fantasy VII, or a version of Cloud. Alright, what do we got? Lambent Hat. Speed plus one. Oh, my Black Mage is gonna love that. Absolutely love it. My Black Mage now has a speed of 8, which is absolutely ridiculous. Ooh, oh. Those are ninja swords. Oh, and a harp. Yes, our bard has a weapon. Not that... Not that our bard will ever use the weapon, but we have it now. I think this is one of the first places to actually buy books. Ninja scroll. Oh, that's dancer cloth. It's a weird weapon, okay. Alright. Alright, that is a nice upgrade. Now, every attack has a chance to disable the target, which... That'll be even better if I can disable mages before they cast. Alright, this was a... This was a good... This was a good find. We did good here. Take like 100 shuriken. Ninjas, thieves, archers. This is just a battle against a bunch of brigands. So just like the Corpse Brigade formed after the war, before the game, these highwaymen formed due to the events of this current war. I'm not forming these sentences as well. The unrest of the people are growing. We're seeing more and more brigands, highwaymen, revolts around the country due to the war. A lot of people are just trying to make a buck. And they see Ramza, the heretic, wanted by the church. And once again, we got people coming after our heads. I can disable these archers. At least one of the archers. I didn't disable him, but he's almost dead. I'm hoping my geomancy can reach the thief over there. Yeah. And we'll get this archer. They're really going after Ramza. Like a regen or a protect or a haste on Ramza? No. Alright, we disabled that archer, so that's nice. going to hide down here and heal myself. That ninja's gonna kill me. Samson? Who's Samson? You're Samson. Well, maybe not. It's possible a shuriken could kill me. Ooh, not even a flare. Not even a flare. If I can't one-shot you, I'm just gonna take you down a little bit. As long as that archer is still disabled, we don't really have anything to fear. And our ninja is really doing work here. Ramza doesn't even have to lift a finger. I should have taught my geomancer the next geomancy, because this is lake. There's a lot of water here. There's gonna be. There's no water at all. It's because we opened the sluice gate. We drained the lake. We're facing off against a bunch of undead. That summoner up top scares me. If I go here, the summoner is just gonna hit me. So I'm gonna go here and get hit by the summoner, even though I know it's gonna happen. Ooh, I even get hit by the archers. Now, because the archers have float on, their range is extended even more. these guys are so fast. We're gonna heal with our Geomancer. Pretty much resetting the fight. Ow. It amazes me just how much damage like a magic class can do with a melee weapon. Can't block summons. We need a regen on our ninja. And we missed. Could have also used a regen on Ramza. Just about everywhere I go. I'm gonna get hit by the archers. Who's Sita? You're Sita. Unfortunate. I'm hoping Sita tries to go attack my ninja and gets blocked. Well, we can't have that. This is the power of the high ground, really. We got screwed here. I'm hoping my ninja can just tank this damage. That summoner. It's actually ridiculous. A re-raise on my ninja would have been really ridiculously helpful. I can't go over there. The ninja's gonna die. Okay, so this is an earth-based geomancy. She has float on, so I can't do anything. I can just come up here and kill her, though. So the church is basically laying out the same poison they used on the armies is the same poison Dystark used to kill his own father. Just a little bit out of time, none the wiser, but eventually it'll catch up to you. Now, Dystark also has that poison in his blood. The church is saying at any time they have the means to just slip a little bit into his meals, into his drinks, they don't even have to lift a finger. They can just sit back and watch Dystark kill himself, basically. So the church is trying to get Dystark to back down, to cease fighting and join their cause. Zalbag overhears everything. Now Zalbag isn't without blood on his hands. He's the one who ordered Argath to shoot Teatra back at the start of the game. But even still, he's his father's son more than Dystark is. He resembles Ramza more than Dystark. So even though he was willing to do bad things in the past, his conscience is starting to catch up with him. Alright. Okay. I'm thinking. So what I want is move plus two, because I don't think move plus one is cutting it right now. Ideally, I'd get move plus three, but that would take a long, long time. Martial arts, brawler, I think that would be fine. This will have to do. We'll spend a battle as an archer. That should give us, as long as we're using her every turn, that should give us enough JP to become a thief. Then we'll stay as a thief until we learn move plus two. Then we'll go back to Geomancer and Monk. We're almost at first strike with Monk. How much was move plus two? Probably 500. That'll take some time to do. I don't think I'll ever use attack boost, but I'll learn it. I believe Dancer on the female melee tree also has move plus three, but that would take a very, very long time to get, so move plus two is probably where we're all in that. And getting move plus two for my black mage might also be good. Getting move plus two on my black mage would be really, really painful, though. I would have to take her down the melee tree, and she would lose all of her magic attack power. where she is. Now, these girls, again, they can cast Ultima on Ramza. I don't know if he has to be a squire to learn it. We'll get another chance, though. Well, that's not good. Well, that's really stupid. You guys just stopped two of my characters just off the bat? I'm afraid I'm gonna have to flare you to death. I can't cure stop with purification. Unfortunate. Okay. You know, when it says defeat all enemies, I assume the victory condition is to defeat all enemies. So, these two, holders of the stones, they're talking as if they're not human anymore. They're talking as if they are themselves the Lukavai. It seems whatever was left of their humanity is now gone. Well, that's not what I wanted to do. I wanted to turn Ramza into a squire, just in case, but... If this is the battle I'm thinking of, it'll be our last chance to get Ultima. So I would have to turn Ramza into a squire. Yeah, this is it. I'm going to reset. I do not know if Ramza being a squire is what causes him to learn Ultima. or if he just has to get hit by it. But better safe than sorry. We just have to defeat the Marquis, but I really want Ultima, and I'm hoping the girls attack Ramza first. Well, that's not supposed to be how that works. Ow. So teleport allows your movement to become infinite, but the farther away you move from your current position, the more likely it is to fail. I may need to give up on Ultima. Yeah, they're not casting it. Casting, stop. Really, okay. The rooftop battle was probably my best chance to get Ultima. They do cast it here, but it's 17% chance to hit. Actually unbearable. Alright, so we won't get Ultima this game. It's fine. Two more JP. Well, now I'm scared of clumping everyone together. So what the Marquis did at the beginning is an example of a samurai weapon skill. He used a samurai sword to unleash a magical melee attack. It's just unfortunate that his teleport actually worked. And that is Argath. I believe Argath is now an undead. The Argath we knew would never align himself with the church like this. He's just being controlled by the Lucubi. Argath was very big on the nobility, and the church is very anti-nobility. I don't actually remember this fight. This might be a PSP exclusive fight. I don't know. So we really just have to kill Argath. Which I am more than happy to do. Oof, okay. And the height difference here is making getting any sort of JP difficult. I at least want my archer to get some JP this fight, so... It's a lot of magic they're casting. Thank you. My only real hope is for my archer to go in and punch Argath. That didn't really feel like a fair fight. I know most fights I completely dominate, but that was like... That's a lot of magic in turn one. Not much I could do. Mom, are we there yet? Nope. On two more attacks. We corner the Marquis, but once again, the Lukavai come. At the very least, this particular fight the minions aren't that bad. They're just normal enemies. Now, Meliadhul has come to kill us, but now she sees the truth of the Zodiac Stones. Isildur's sister now knows what the church is plotting. It's my soul, what happened right there. This is gonna be pretty hard for us to fight. So either a black mage or a bard are going to die here. It really sucks. Really stupid. There's nothing I can do to... Best I can do is kill that guy, stand here. I'm clumping up for a heal, but the boss is actually just gonna Firaja me again. The fact that all these enemies get to go first is what really makes this so hard. Boss can fly, so I can't really... This is going to be difficult. I don't know how to stop this. As long as this guy right here... At the very least, I'm too slow to actually deal any significant damage. So, I need to run away. He's going to die again, that's fine. But the boss is really fast. Oh, he's running away. That's okay. Well, that's not fun. I just need to keep the pressure on with my ninja. She's doomed, she's gonna die. We need to keep going. Man, he's so fast. Thank you. I don't remember where the boss is actually casting his spell. That's mostly fine. Okay. Good job, people. So with that out of the way, Miliadul recovers the stone, but she is more willing to accept our words now. So now we know that Dystar has a Zodiac Stone, and we know what happens to people with stones. Meliadul joins us. She's a divine knight, like Agrius. Or, not exactly. I wonder what the differences are between them. Let's check. Meliadul. I see. So, Meliadul just knows how to destroy things at range. She's a knight, but can do so at range. Not terrible, but not good. Her crush abilities also deal damage, though, unlike the knight's Ren's ability. So not bad, not bad. I'll take your stuff, though. Monk, we are one battle away. And we get move plus two, automatically. Part of me is tempted to remain in Archer to get concentration, but I don't think I'd ever use it, so. We'll switch back to Monk for a little bit. I guess more than a little bit. We need like 1,036 JP. I need 900 JP. What do I need to unlock Thief? It's Archer 3. So, one okay battle as an Archer, I could unlock Archer. And we could go to Thief to get move plus 2. So next time, Ramza's gonna return home. Actually, I'm sorry. Let's actually spend some... Let's check this out first. What's the air knife? Wind elemental blade. All right, now we'll call it an episode. Next time we'll return home and confront Dice Dark. Until then, I'll see you.